Do not stand at my grave and weep. I am not there. I do not sleep. I am a thousand winds that blow. I am the diamond glints on snow. I am the sunlight on ripened grain. I am the gentle autumn rain. When you awaken in the morning hush, I am the swift uplifting rush of quiet birds in circled flight. I am the soft stars that shine at night. Do not stand at my grave and cry. I am not there. I did not die.
They were men and women, mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters, aunts, uncles, friends, and colleagues. But most of all, they were people who served in the armed forces of their country. Soldiers, sailors, airmen, guardsmen, and marines. They made the ultimate sacrifice. Their physical bodies may have ceased to continue on, but their spirits and memories live on in those who remember them. Memorial Day in the United States. Originally known as Decoration Day, no one is really sure when it started out, but in 1966, President Lyndon Johnson declared Waterloo, New York, as its official birthplace. Memorial Day was officially proclaimed on May 5, 1868, by General John Logan, and was first observed on May 30, 1868, when flowers were placed on the graves of Union and Confederate soldiers at Arlington National Cemetery. In the United States, we observe Memorial Day on the last Monday in May. We also observe what we call Veterans Day on November 11th. In many other countries, this day is known as Remembrance Day. It is used to commemorate the end of fighting on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month of the war to end all wars. That day was known as Armistice Day. In Australia and New Zealand, they have Anzac Day to remember those who fought and died in many wars. In the United States, we honor our war dead on Memorial Day. Many people have forgotten the true meaning of Memorial Day. Their thoughts are on picnics and parties, having an extra day off of work, or just plainly to goof off. This year, let us all remember, no matter what country you're in, what religion you follow, what political leaning you have, your views on war and peace, pay tribute to those who gave their lives in the service of their country. It is the soldier, not the reporter, who has given us the freedom of the press. It is the soldier, not the poet, who has given us freedom of speech. It is the soldier, not the organizer, who has given us the freedom to demonstrate. It is the soldier who salutes the flag, who serves beneath the flag, and whose coffin is draped by the flag, who allows the protesters to burn the flag.
I can touch your flag-draped coffin and tearfully say goodbye. I can lower my flag to half-staff after flying it high. I can fix your family a meal and watch your kids while they heal. It's just not enough. I want to play a song for you. It's the very least I can do as you go along to the heavens. Higher than I can see. I want to give you my breath because you gave your last breath for me.